What would you be doing if you wasn't doing hair?
A stripper.
Hey guys, I'm Johnny Wright, celebrity hairstylist and also the new style correspondent here at Thegrio. You may know me best for my work with forever First Lady Michelle Obama, but I started doing hair at the early age of 12. Throughout the years, I've been able to work with some of the best image makers in the game, and I wanted to give them an opportunity to share their stories with you, the viewers. Welcome to Black Glam. These are the people that make your favorite stars shine. What's up, Grio fam? It is your boy, Johnny Wright. I am here live at my downtown Los Angeles loft, and I am even more excited to have another one of my favorite people, Tym Wallace. What's up, Tim?
What's going on, Johnny?
Let me just tell you a little bit about Tim. He works with some of the major celebrities out there. You know, first of all, Taraji P. Henson.
Cookie.
Cardi B. Yara Shahidi. Mary J. Blige. And the list goes on and on and on. And your work is exceptional.
I appreciate you just taking me under your wings and always encouraging me and just being that person.
Of course,
it's
of course.
Such a pleasure, and I'm honored to be here.
Yay.
As well.
All right, so let's take me back. Take me back to the moment, the time that you said to yourself, I want to be a hairstylist.
The day I started cosmetology school.
Really? You wanted to be a lawyer?
I wanted to be a lawyer.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yes.
Tell me more about that. What was a lawyer?
Where did that come from? Wanted to be a lawyer. I thought my whole life until senior year in high school when I was like, no, school isn't for me. It's not going to happen. So that's out the picture.
Yeah, I had that moment too. I was like, yeah, I'm good on this.
That's out the picture.
Yeah.
So honestly, it was, you know, God was just like, I think this is the direction I want to take you in.
So. Yeah. Let me tell you something about Tim. Tim has a strong and deep love and relationship with the Lord.
I love God, but I still turn up. I wish I would have worn my sweat. I have a sweatshirt that says, I love Jesus, but I cuss a little.
And or a lot.
Or a lot.
So who was your first celebrity client?
My first celebrity client, God. None other than NeNe Leakes.
Really?
Yes.
How did that happen?
A client of mine by the name of Kiafa Vick, she's the wife of Michael Vick. They were good friends, and at the time I was living in Philadelphia, she came to the city and needed her hair done.
Awesome.
And it's like the rest is history.
We have to talk about home. I mean, we're both from Chicago.
Absolutely.
Did you start doing hair in Chicago initially, right?
In Chicago.
What age were you when you started?
I got into hair school 19.
19, so pretty early.
Yeah. I was so hungry to move to New York and take things, you know, to the next level and get into this career. I was like, look, I'll live on the street. I'll go to a shelter.
Wow.
As long as I got these hands, I'll be all right. Give me a month in New York, I'll be good.
I just want you all to realize something. That is a manifestatious possibility mind right there. He just said that he was willing to sleep on the streets because he knew that give him a month, he'll figure it out. I think that's awesome that you did that. And you went to Philly because it was close enough to New York.
It was close enough to New York.
Mm-hmm.
When I first started going, I was going to do Fashion Week.
Okay.
And I wasn't even actually on the teams. I was assisting the
team. No key. He wasn't a key.
I wasn't a key.
Yeah.
I wasn't a part of the team. I was assisting the assistants to the team. And
which is great.
Which is
good.
You
learn a lot in that.
You
have
to crawl before you walk.
Yes, yes.
It does not happen overnight.
Yes.
So, I pay my dues.
So you are always so extremely busy. Extremely busy. And here recently, you've had something to make you realize that you need to save some time to yourself. You had a little bit of a health threat.
4 weeks ago? I woke up with a lot of pressure on my chest, and I was really short of breath. And I, of course, thinking I'm Superman, I'm like, I'll go see about it later. I'm like, maybe my body is just telling me I need to rest, in which I'll work my body until it says, sit your ass down.
Right.
And went to the emergency room, and after all the tests came back, I found out that I had 3 blood clots on my leg. And I mean, on my lung, and one in my leg.
Wow. Frightening.
It was the scariest thing ever.
Yeah.
The scariest. My mother,
particularly,
at 32, had a blood clot in her leg, and it traveled to her heart, and she had a heart attack and passed away. And it scared the living shit out of me.
I understand. I think it's really cool to kind of get a little bit of a nudge to say, take care of yourself, because this industry can eat you alive. Those who you are inspiring and aspiring to be a part of this industry, it's a beautiful industry to be a part of, but you gotta take care of yourself. Tell me an icon you would do in heaven.
Prince.
Prince?
Yes.
See, I've always said Whitney Houston, but I have my reasons why Prince.
Because I just know Prince would give me so much shade, and it would just make me laugh so much.
That is so funny. He probably would give me so much shade.
His shade and reason.
Some purple
amazing.
Shade on top of that. How do you want to be remembered?
A person that had a lot of love for everybody and just give love.
Yeah. That's I love it. That.
Just
and you do
love.
Give me love. And I will continue to give you love.
And I appreciate it. I take it and I'm gonna give it.
This is my heart and joy right here. I'm so happy that I convinced him to move to downtown Los Angeles.
Yes, he did.
When he's like, I'm gonna move to LA. I was like, yo, we'll move downtown. And he's like 3 blocks away from me, so it's make it even better. Yeah. We have a family of friends here and we have so much fun together. We support each other, we love each other.
Definitely
we have a
do.
Great time and we have a good old turn-up time.
Yes, we do.
But it was really nice to sit down and let the world see what I know about you, especially on Thegrio. And this has been Black Glam, guys. So thank you for tuning in.
Thank you for having me.
Bye,
thank
guys.
You.